Hello there everyone, how is it going? You are watching another segment brought to you by Studio Infinity. If you have been one of our viewers, watching this you might already know what's going on, or else you might be a bit confused. Well, this is new. This is Success Stories with me, myself. Hello, I am Jananga, bringing you my first episode. I hope most of you are familiar with our parallel segment called Success Stories with Nabade. Well, this is the same concept presented to you, but in English language. So today, when you clicked or tapped this video, I'm sure you saw two unknown individuals appeared on your computer screen, mobile screen, or whatever the device you view this on. But right now, I think one of those individuals introduced himself, which was me. So, who is the other guy? Who is he? Ladies and gentlemen, he is the man behind the high jumping technique, the Fosbury Flop. He is Dick Fosbury, a civil engineer who went on to Olympics and left his name in the glistening skies of sports, specifically using his ability to think outside the box. So today, we are talking about his story. And I'm sure at the end of this episode, you will decide whether it was a success story. Until then, all you have to do is just listen. So, during the 1968 Olympic Games, right in front of a crowd of 80,000 people, an unknown athlete, Dick Fosbury, prepared to complete his first attempt at the high jump event. Up till this day, Fosbury had a very average athletic track record. As a teenager, he failed to break into his high school basketball team despite his towering height of 6 feet and 4 inches. Fosbury literally flopped at his attempts at various disciplines within athletics. Eventually, he settled with the high jump event because it was the best of his athletic flops. Even so, Fosbury didn't reach the qualifying heights of his local club in his first attempts. But still, the stage was set for this average high jump athlete. Fosbury, a 21-year-old student with a major in civil engineering, bad feet and with weak physical stature. A general statement was made. He would fail at his Olympic high jump attempts and go home without even having a medal. Did he? Let's see. Prior to Fosbury's Olympic event, athletes relied on three techniques. Those were the scissors, Western roll, and straddle jump. These all had one thing in common. They were designed to give the athlete the opportunity to land on their feet after clearing the bar. But Fosbury knew that he had a little chance of competing with the top athletes using those techniques. Well, he was right, because those were their techniques. He really knew that he had to come up with something of his own. So, he was a civil engineer. He gathered the interesting theories on center of gravity and whatnot with his huge will to become a great athlete. So, what was the result that came out? Well, instead of jumping face forward using the conventional straddle technique, Fosbury jumped off the wrong foot, arched his back, and cleared the bar backwards. Immediately, Fosbury received heavy criticism from his coaches and the press for his unconventional jumping technique. A local newspaper even called him the world's laziest high jumper. See? So this will happen when you try to do something which is not in their books, and some of them make sure to do everything in their power to just stop you. So does it mean that you have to stop? Did Fosbury stop? Again, let's see. The heavy criticism did not stop Dick Fosbury from perfecting his new Fosbury flop technique, even though all the odds were against him. Up until the 1960s, high jump athletes cleared the bar and landed on hard ground, you know, sawdust, sand, and low mats. As a result, innovation of the high jump techniques attempted to ensure that the athletes landed, always landed on their feet. I suggest you all to watch one of those old Charlie Chaplin kind of high-speed video footages to see how those earlier men did their jump. Despite of you being finding it a bit hilarious, you will also find those earlier jumps to be risky. Well, it's like if a man competes for high jump in Olympics this time, he's more likely to compete in Para-Olympics the next time. I must say, I do mean no offense towards the respectable event which is Paralympics or to their athletes who are amazing hard workers. My point is, the earlier events of high jumping were risky. So if Fosbury used his technique and jump in an environment as said above and land on his back, I'm sure we would turn a different chapter in the history book to find Mr. Fosbury's name. Because obviously it was a must to have a matrix to use his special technique. But luckily at the time Fosbury competed, they had matrices after the bar in the high jump events. Back to the Olympics 1968. It was his opportunity to showcase this new high jump technique of his own. Prior to Fosbury's first attempt at the high jump, three men had already stepped up and cleared the bar using the straddle technique. Then up next came Dick Fosbury, the unknown lanky young man wearing a green top, white shorts and Adidas trainers. As he approached the high jump mat, he did his thing, launched off the wrong foot, arched his back and cleared the bar backwards. Within a few moments, everyone watching and hearing went bananas after hearing their new winner in the high jump Olympics. He who won over all other world-class athletes who used their conventional strategies of just doing it. Fosbury shocked the world by setting a new Olympic world record by clearing a height of 2.24 meters with the Fosbury flop technique, ended up winning the gold medal in the process. Within a few years after this event, the Fosbury flop would become the conventional technique for the high jump athlete. Since 1972 till this date, every single Olympic gold medalist and record holder has successfully used the Fosbury flop. So, what did we come up with our story today? You can do great, reach massive heights and be the titans in your chosen fields by just trusting your guts. And Dick Fosbury inspires us to follow what he followed. It is to be original, think outside the box. It doesn't matter whether you are an entrepreneur, an engineer, a teacher, an artist, or even a YouTube personality who might be talking about men that jump so high straight away for like 7-8 minutes. Get tipped by others, get taught by others, but still be original. So, Dick Fosbury, yeah, what a man has he been. And what a man my man Vibhuda has been by just suggesting me to do the story of Dick Fosbury for my first episode. So, big shout out to you, Vibhuda. And here we are at the end of our today's episode. So, it's me, Jananga, signing out from our first episode of Success Stories with Jananga, hoping to bring you all another inspiring story in an upcoming week. I must mention, you will also get to watch our next episode, another one from Success Stories with Nambade. So, until I meet you again, yeah, stay cool.
Your Infinity YouTube channel, like a subscribe, bell icon, click.